Man, what an intro.
Glory to God. Hope everybody's doing well. My name is Brian Knight. Welcome to the show. This is Monday, April the 6th, 2020. Man, what a great day. You know, it's been raining. It's still off and on raining here in San Antonio. But you know what? Glory to God. The sun is on the throne. He's still ruling and reigning. There's still things still change when you put faith in him. So, how can things be bad? Glory to God. I know that, you know, the world around us, you know, there's crazy things happening around us. Disease, famine, death, war. But praise God, Jesus is still alive. And that's huge. I mean, that's everything to me. You know, once you meet Jesus, once you get in the presence of the Most High God, you can never go back. I mean, I know that you hear people talking on different videos, podcasts, interviews, you know, thinking about, you know, they can't believe in God and they don't believe in anything spiritual. Let me tell you what. You've come too late for me. Praise God. I mean, I know who he is, and I know whose I am. Man, it's marvelous. Marvelous to know Jesus. I encourage you, get with him. Sit with him. Right? Sit with him. He's the one. He's the one who sets everything good. Praise God. Praise God. Well, if you have your Bibles, I know you do. If you don't, read along, listen along. We're going to go back to Psalms or 103. You know, it's in the past. You know, past few days, I've been talking about. I've been talking about covenant, our protection in covenant, something that I need to spend time on, and I don't feel it right now, but is getting the Americans, right, people of the United States, the West, we really don't know and understand covenant. We don't really know what it means to be a brother. You know, of course, we don't make blood covenants anymore. We have the final blood covenant, Jesus. But covenants for thousands of years were it, man. That's the agreement. You don't break those. Yeah, you do everything possible. Everything possible not to break that covenant. If you broke that covenant, that's your word. That's your bond. And you know what? Curses come. Covenant's it, man. Especially in places like Africa and other parts of the country where you make agreements with other tribes and other nations. And you don't just do it with a piece of paper. You do it in blood. Right? Dr. Stanley went over to Africa and he wrote a book about it. You know, he took along his goat for milk. He was you know, he had a stomach problem, and all he could drink was goat's milk. But when he made that covenant with the tribal leader, everything changed. He took that staff with him. Everybody knew this man has high authority, Dr. Stanley, all because of that covenant that he made with this leader of the community, this leader of that area. It's everything. Everything. What happens? Things change hands. Names change. Remember we read this back a few days ago in the book of Genesis. The names were changed when God made a covenant. When the Most High, El Shaddai, when he made a covenant with Abraham, Abram, and Sarai. He changed their names to Abraham and Sarah. Right? That was for a reason. It was a sign oh, this man is now a covenant partner with God Almighty. The father of many nations is what he's called. Right? So it's there's significance. So significance in a covenant exchange. All those who are married listening. Right? You followed with that same covenant. You got married. And what happened? The woman changed her last name. No longer is she Smith, but now she's Mr. and Mrs. Johnson or Mr. and Mrs. whatever. Right? Washington. Because of covenant, you entered into a binding covenant. That's why marital relationship, sexual relationship, there's a covenant happens. God set it up so that when they first come together, there's blood being shed. It's blood covenant. It's powerful. Of course, you know, a lot of times sexual immorality and promiscuity, it's just rampant. So it doesn't mean anything to most people, but it's still real. It's still a covenant binding act when you make agreement to do that. Things change in the spirit world, in the spiritual realm. So anyway, covenant is huge, man, and we need to talk about that more on this podcast, but let's finish this up. This Psalms 103. I just want to keep going just so we can get this in you. Let's just look at verse 10. For he has not dealt with us after our sins, glory to God, but he has not rewarded us according to our iniquities. Number one, Psalms 103. For as heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward us, or towards them that fear him, or reverence him, or honor him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. Like a father pities his children, so the Lord pities them that fear him, and not in a bad way. For he knows our frame. He remembers we are dust. As a man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field. So he flourishes. For the wind passes over it, and it's gone, and the place thereof shall know it no more. But the mercy of the Lord, the mercy of God. Man, God's merciful. No matter what comes, sickness, disease, weather, tragedy, accidents, God is so gracious. And he has an answer to everything. Everything. Glory to God. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting. What a promise. 103:17. His mercy is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto children's children. Stand right now. Just claim it. My righteousness, and God's righteousness, is upon my children and their children's children. Praise God. I declare that in the name of Jesus over my family and over your family. Just receive that in the name of Jesus. Verse 18, to such as keep his covenant, and to those that remember his commandments to do them, the Lord has prepared his throne in the heavens. And his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, ye his angels that excel in strength, and that do his commandments, hearkening unto the voice of his word. Bless ye the Lord, all his hosts, ye ministers of his that do his pleasure. Bless the Lord, all his works in all the places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Glory to God. So so many benefits. Let's flip over Hebrews chapter 1. Let's look at that for a second. Let's just read it. And, you know, a lot of times people don't get the word, but let's read it. For God, Hebrews 1:1. For God, who in sundry times and in divers manners spoke unto the past to our fathers, the prophets, by the prophets, has in these last days spoken to us by his Son, whom he's appointed heir of all things. Oh, look at that. Jesus is heir of all things. Well, of course he is. And guess what? You are joint heir with Jesus. Philippians. Joint heir.
Glory to God.
Glory to God. That's good, man. By whom the worlds were made, who being the brightness of his glory, the express image of his person, upholding all the things by the word of his power, when he made himself purge our sins and sat on the right hand of majesty on high, being made so much better than the angels, he by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. For which under the angels said he at any time, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee, and again I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. And again, when he bringeth in the first begotten into the world, he saith, let all the angels of God worship him. Now, that's a pretty high statement. Remember, we're talking about Jesus here. And we're talking about a covenant. This is God making a covenant. God making Jesus God. And let all the angels of God worship him. And the angels, he saith, who maketh his angel spirits and his ministers a flame of fire, but unto the Son, thy throne, O God, is forever and ever, and a scepter of righteousness is the scepter of your kingdom. You have loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore, God, even my God, even your God, has anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows, and thou, Lord, in the beginning has laid the foundations of the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hands. They will perish, but you remain, and all shall wax old as a garment, and as a vesture shalt thou fold them up, and you shall be changed, and they shall be changed, but thou art the same, and your years shall not fail. But to which of the angels will he say at any time, sit on my right hand until I make my enemies my footstool? Are not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister to those who are heirs of salvation? All that. To get to that. We are heirs of salvation. Heirs of all things. And we have angelic beings on our side as well. We have all kinds of benefits, man. All kinds of benefits as a born-again man and woman of God. So hang on to that. Hang on to that. That the righteousness of God extends to us by faith. It's so great. I mean, praise God. It's such a magnificent... Well, why are you talking about just this? Because that's what you have to do. That's how you look in the Word of God. You remind yourself. You learn and remind yourself over and over, day after day, about the goodness of God and what He is and what He's done. Right? And the next verse even says it. The next verse even says it. Chapter 2:1. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip or run... It says, like, run out like a leaking vessel. So you get filled up, but it runs out. You got to continue to fill. For if the word spoken by the angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which was at first began to be spoken to us by the Lord, and was confirmed to us by them that heard it? Then God also bearing with witnesses, both signs and wonders and divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. Praise God. So you have to remind yourself. So even though we read and look over Psalms 103, you have to go in and continue to do so on a daily basis. That's why the scripture says that you should renew your mind. Right? Renew your mind with the Word of God. Right? Romans 12, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You're right? That you can prove what is good and perfect and acceptable, the will of God. So, a daily process. You know, James even goes on to say that it's the saving of our soul that's a process, our mind, will, and emotions, right? Those things aren't born again. You have to take them under advisement, right? What they say to you very well could be a totally different thing. Totally different than what you're thinking could be reality. The mind, the will, the emotions. Right? And Pastor Courtney, a friend of mine, my pastor I go to, he says, in imaginations. You have to renew that with the Word of God. It's key, man. It's totally key. It's difficult to go through this life and not pick up this Bible. You know why? Because every wind of doctrine, every emotional problem, it'll take you under. Man, every fear out there, every torment, every terrorism, if that's even how to say it, every terrorist act, it's fear. And that will change your life for the worse. Unless you have a foundation of the Word of God. The Word of God will stand forever, and you can stand on it forever. Just like this whole virus situation here, this COVID-19, which we declare in Jesus' name, that it's ending quickly. You don't have to be afraid and fearful. Praise God, you don't have to be that way. You can stand strong against it. Let's pray against it right now. Right? This whole COVID, this virus, flu virus, that attacks the lungs, the respiratory system. Agree with me. I'm going to pray against this thing. Agree with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, we stand in agreement together according to the living Word of God. Jesus said in John 16, I assure you, most solemnly I tell you, that my Father will grant you whatever you ask in my name. And he said in Mark 11, whatsoever you ask in prayer, believe that it is granted to you. It says, believe, trust, and be confident. Thank you, Lord. Now we pray that no evil shall befall us, neither shall any plague come near our dwelling. We pray protection from all effects of this coronavirus. We take authority over it in Jesus' name. We take authority right now. It will not touch us, not touch our families. And God has highly exalted Jesus and given him a name that's above every name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee bows and every tongue confesses on earth and on heaven. Under heaven, praise God. So coronavirus, you have a name. You are a name. And you bow the name, you bow your knee to the name of Jesus, which is above every name. The name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, is for our protection from disease. Glory to God. And God will supply all our needs according to his wishes and glory. His riches and glory, rather. We believe, agree with me, we believe together that God is the source of everything we need during this time. He is our provider. He's our supplier. We will not fall short financially or in any other way. Thank you, Lord. He is our supplier. Everything we need, we have it. And God has, remember this. Lord, we agree and we remember that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Praise God. And we refuse to fear. We refuse to panic. We refuse to worry. And we cast all our cares and anxieties over unto you, Lord, because you care for us. Thank you. Lord, thank you for the freedom from fear. Thank you for freedom from any anxiety, any mind situation that might overwhelm us through this whole situation. Lord, you are God and we love you. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. And Father, we love you. We just praise you. We thank you that you've given our government, our authorities, according to 1 Timothy 2, that you've given them wisdom. We give thanks for them, Father. We give thanks for the kings and all ministers and people in authority, that we can live a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. And we pray for the president of the United States and all the world leaders in authority, that they walk in the highest degree of God's wisdom. And we pray for the medical professionals, public health officials, first responders, all involved. And Lord, it's your will that all men be saved. And because of this whole global door has been opened, we ask that you move across the whole world, Lord God. Oh, we pray for an awakening to happen in our nation to our mighty Savior and compassionate healer. And as a result, Father, we pray that all men know and declare Jesus is Lord. And we declare that we have victory over the coronavirus in Jesus' name. Satan, we bind you and your forces and we render you helpless. Glory to God. And we loose the angels to go forth and minister on our behalf. We are healed, protected. We are prosperous, free from fear. And we plead the blood of Jesus over our lives. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise God. Now, if you agree with that, say amen. Hallelujah. Because Jesus is Lord. Glory to God. I love it. He is. Thank you. Thank you for agreeing with me. Thank you for agreeing with me. Remember, God is on our side. Who can stand against you? No one. No coronavirus. Nothing. Nothing. Praise God. It's wonderful. Truly glorious that God has given us faith and hope to stand against anything that comes our way. Hallelujah. So I'm going to wrap it up. But continue this mindset. Until next time, continue this mindset. Right? This isn't the answer is to continue forward in faith. Pushing forward every day. Standing against every day the wiles of the enemy, whether it's disease or famine or whatever he might bring about. Remember Job, he brought all kinds of things, destruction, disease, loss. But praise God, when you stand in faith, he brings double. Hallelujah. The book of Job, we have to get into the book of Job. God is good. Well, I love you guys. I hope you continue. I continue this. Oh, on another note, did some squatting yesterday with the barbell. Man, felt good. Did 30 sets at 100 kilos, or 10 sets at 100 kilos. Felt good. Felt good this morning. Wasn't too sore. My ribs are a little sore, but that's good. I mean, barbell work is always essential. Got to do that daily. Remember, the barbell never lies to you. Other people might lie to you, but the barbell never lies to you. It's pretty fabulous, actually. The barbell is the answer to all your problems. It can be, for sure. It can't be. Well, I love y'all. And I pray that y'all have a great rest of your day. If you're listening to this in the morning, if you're listening to this in the evening, you know, have a good night and hang on to Jesus. That's the answer. That's the answer. There's no other way. There's no other way about it.